My name is Indrajit and I live at the foothill of Mount Ginnar. I am proposing a theory. This theory cannot be proved, unfortunately. To proving it, that means you have to implement it. To implement it, that is, the situation is so much drastic that you need this theory. We are facing existential challenge. What is our challenge? The challenge of existence. Whether we will live a decade, 2 decades, 4 decades before we get exited from this land called India. This is our ancestral land. Our culture has been continuous tens of thousands of years. Oldest is Sindhukin Sanskriti, Harappa, Ramayana, Mahabharata, Gangetic Sanskriti, Narmada. Civilization is a continuous one. People come, people merge, but the basic stock is the same. We change our language, we change our food habits, we change our behavior. We have adopted Arabic religions and Mediterranean religions, sects, faiths, languages, foods. Up till this time, there was no problem. We were 85% of this continent, that is India. Why now? The reason is many things, and one of the reason is the state is not protecting its own majority in numerous. State is doing everything to protect its numerically minority. This minority has become so much prevalent with lots of benefits that it is challenging the existence of majority. Majority is undivided. Minority is a single political unit. So any political party which subscribes to it can get all those chunk of votes, and as we have seen in the political duck series, what political parties want is a chunk of what, dedicated votes. We are facing the existential challenge, and our challenge is in a society, our existence, our residence, our food, our culture, our language, our habit, the state enactment of laws, and most important challenge is we are not able to reach our faith. It's one of the hardest thing that we are not able to reach our faith. Because for us, faith was one of the most important thing from our religion. All the aspects of life came, be it a Sanskrit language, be it a kingship things, be it a food, be it a work, be it a economy, temple structures. All those things emanated from the religion. it, day by day it has becoming very hard to practice it, and the Arabic culture is taking over all aspects of the life, that we have to give them considerations, we have to accommodate them, we have to be second citizen, and we have to face loads and loads of hardship. Only thing is, they are giving a resistance in a united way. Their whole existence, their whole life is dedicated to expanding their own faith, their own religion. But for us, this is our homeland. This is the land where we, generation to generation, born here. We have not come from anywhere. We have developed here. So this existential challenge, we are not able to cope with it, because the state machinery has a limited things. It has a very immense powerful weapons, powerful ideas, powerful think tanks, but state is bound by the book, and their book does not recognize that we majority people are facing the problem, and state is not doing anything, and we are also not doing anything. This is the root of everything. To think about what we are facing, we have to meet in a small group, whatever our faculty, we come together, make a group, and we decide these areas we have to explore. Then we invite other peoples, we invite the technical peoples, we invite the experts, we invite and make a bigger group, that you people are expert in this, think over it. What is the problem? What is the solution? What solution is desirable and what solution can be implemented by every person? Make a report. Another group deals with another aspect of our culture. Another group deals with another aspect. If someone is doing the similar work, we don't replicate it, we borrow their work. And throughout the country, we make a loose union where we each come together and study and make a research report. What exactly we are facing? What is our problem? Once we find the problem, we all know that our root problem is, it can be put into a one sentence, theory of rape, loot, you got it. But to develop the resistance, we need lot of thinkings, lot of think tanks, and lot of work. And it's time we start doing it. Once the report is made, we spread it. Other people also read it, comment it, and make it a popular thing. Our aim is to create a cultural minimum that we can say to the politicians, to the religious leaders, to the social leaders, that you don't have to go down beyond this level. We create a level on the basis of these reports that this is our cultural thing. We don't let them shut down that you people are good people, you don't do this, you people are big people, you people are this, that. No, it is a matter of existence. So we give them that this is our cultural level. You don't have to go down, and we make that acceptable. Lot of problem will vanish. Most of the Hindu people don't want to fight. It's a good thing. At least we can maintain our culture level. This way, we don't come into tussle with the state, police, politicians, social leaders, religion, judiciary. But we give them, this is our culture, this is our level. You rise up to that level. You don't say that you come to our level. No, this is the real culture of India, and you have to rise up to that culture. And this is the one of the easiest solution we can think of it, we can implement in a democratic setup, and which does not require too much efforts. Once a report is made on particular aspect of the culture, we accept it and we make it a cultural thing. You can change the religion, you can change the language, but culture is inherited one. We have to find out that culture, we have to define that parameters, and we have to define the benchmark. We all follow that benchmark, that will be good for all of us.